What is going on, people? It is your boy Daddy Mac, and welcome back to a brand new Pokemon Sword and Shield video. Last week we talked about EVs and IVs in depth. This week I'm gonna teach you guys more about competitive battling. We're gonna go ahead and talk about how you can breed and control your IVs for those of you who are just getting started into competitive battling, or those who are wanting to learn more about competitive battling. Let's get started. In competitive battling, it's safe to say that every stat matters. If you miss a specific speed IV, for example, it may determine whether or not your Pokemon will outspeed your opponent's Pokemon, which can be a difference maker in competitive battling. If you are confused as to what IVs are, I would highly suggest that you check out the previous video where I explain what IVs are. But above all else, let's talk about how you can maximize your Pokemon's potential with IV breeding in just a few steps. Step 1. Catch a Ditto with good IVs. The first step to breed a competitive Pokemon is going to be to catch a Ditto. Ditto is a Pokemon that can breed with almost any Pokemon, with the exception of legendary Pokemon, mythical Pokemon, and anybody else within the undiscovered egg group. What you'll want to do is catch multiple Ditto with different natures, as you will want to have a variety when breeding a specific Pokemon, as natures do matter. At the same time, you'll want your Ditto to have a minimum of 3 IVs in order to pass down to the offspring Pokemon. At the very minimum, you'll want 2 Ditto with IVs in different stats. What I mean by this is that you'll want to have 1 Ditto with IVs in HP, Attack, and Defense, and another Ditto with IVs in Special Attack, Special Defense, and Speed. There are some Ditto with 6 IVs available as well, but they are very, very rare. There are a couple of ways that you can get your hands on these kinds of Ditto, but we won't go into depth as far as that goes. One thing for sure is that if you want to get your hands on one, it's going to make the process a whole lot easier, so I would highly recommend that you do some research on how to obtain a high IV Ditto. Step number 2, gather breeding items. Once you catch your Ditto, you'll want to gather items that will allow you to pass down IVs. You will need the following items: 1 Destiny Knot, 1 Everstone, 1 Power Weight, 1 Power Bracer, 1 Power Belt, 1 Power Lens, 1 Power Band, 1 Power Anklet, 1 Oval Charm, and 1 Shiny Charm. The Destiny Knot and the Everstone are items that are required in order to pass down the nature and the IVs of the desired Pokemon. Most of these items are optional, but they can help you in the long run. What the power items do is they pass down 1 guaranteed IV from the parent Pokemon to the offspring Pokemon. For example, if you have one of the parent Pokemon hold a Power Weight, this will guarantee an HP IV to be passed down to the offspring. Power Bracer will do the same thing for the attack, Power Belt for defense, Lens for special attack, Power Band for special defense, and Power Anklet for the speed IV. The Oval Charm is really, really helpful in terms of getting Pokemon eggs. The Oval Charm increases the rate in which your Pokemon will lay an egg. The Shiny Charm, on the other hand, can be pretty useful when you are trying to breed for a shiny Pokemon. I have come to the situation a handful of times where I am breeding for IVs and randomly hatch a shiny Pokemon, so that's pretty nice. Step number 3. Keep the eggs warm. Once you gather your items, you'll want a Pokemon with Flame Body or Magma Armor. The biggest reason why you want one of these Pokemon is because it cuts the amount of time it takes for an egg to hatch by half. In the Galar region, you'll want anyone from the Colossal line, Tentascorch line via hidden ability, or the Chandelure line. During the breeding process, you'll want this Pokemon at the top of your party, and I also recommend that you have it hold a Smoke Ball, because if your Pokemon is underleveled and you run into a wild battle, your Pokemon can run without failure. Step 4. Determine the Pokemon's nature. Once you get the Pokemon you want to breed, you'll first want to breed for its nature. Grab the Ditto that has the nature you want and the Pokemon you want to breed for. Have the Ditto hold an Everstone and put both Pokemon in the daycare. Once you take a couple of steps or go around in your bike, the nursery worker will cross her arms. Congratulations, this means that you have an egg waiting for you. Talk to the nursery worker, grab the egg, walk around some more, and the egg will hatch. If you do this correctly, your offspring will have the nature your Ditto has. Be sure to check your Pokemon's IVs by using the IV checker and mark the Pokemon's best stats. Step 5. Time to breed the perfect Pokemon. Once you hatch the Pokemon with the nature you desire, talk to the nursery lady and collect both the Ditto and the Pokemon you're trying to breed for. Next, you'll want to give the new baby Pokemon your Everstone and give the Ditto your Destiny Knot and drop your Pokemon off in the daycare. This time, you'll want to fill your party with eggs, and once they hatch, you'll want to get the Pokemon with the most best IVs. Once you determine which Pokemon has the most best IVs, switch the new baby Pokemon with the Pokemon you're wanting to breed for. Leave the Ditto inside of the daycare. The idea is to switch the Pokemon in the daycare, both the Ditto and the parent Pokemon, with the highest IVs possible, and keep breeding until you'll eventually get a Pokemon with the 5 IVs and the stats that you're wanting to get. This process can get a little tedious at times, but I highly recommend you take your time with it and be patient. In no time, you'll have a perfect Pokemon. There is also another method to get your Pokemon's IVs without breeding. This process, however, can be a little bit time-consuming and takes a little bit of grinding. This method is known as Hyper Training. This is a feature that was introduced in Generation 7, and what you'll need to do is get your Pokemon to level 100. Once you level your Pokemon up to level 100, you'll need to obtain a bottle cap or a gold bottle cap. You can obtain a bottle cap in different ways. You can do so by doing max rate battles, spending BP at the battle tower, or participate in ranked battles and earn in-game rewards such as bottle caps, mints, vitamins, BP, and more. Once you have your bottle cap and your level 100 Pokemon, head towards the battle tower, talk to the league employee in the left, and he will hyper train your Pokemon. And there you have it, the 5 steps needed in order to breed the perfect competitive Pokemon. We also threw in a little bit of a bonus lesson, hyper training. If you enjoyed this video or simply found it useful, be sure to drop a like, comment your thoughts down below, and also subscribe to my channel. We do Pokemon battles every single week. You're not going to want to miss any Pokemon content. But above all else, thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate your time. I hope you guys have yourself a great day, and I'll see you guys next time.